We're going to start with some Thanksgiving inspired would you rathers. Would you rather wash your hair in mashed potatoes or bathe in gravy?
Maybe wash your hair with mashed potatoes. I feel like there's maybe some like stuff in there that'll make my hair shiny.
That's
and
what
healthy.
I was thinking. I'd be interested in seeing how that works. That might be what I need to be doing. Might find that out.
Can you imagine bathing in something that you really want to eat?
Well, the problem is I wouldn't mind being in the bath of gravy. Like, that would be great. I could dip my food in there. I could drink gravy straight from the tub.
But your naked body's in the tub.
Yeah,
also.
But I mean, come on. When you're a little kid, you drink that water. You're fine. You drink that water when you're a kid. Okay. But
drink
the problem
it now,
is,
though.
Once you get out of the gravy bath, you're going to feel like you need a shower.
Right.
You're going to be covered in gravy grease. Can't be doing that. So give me the potatoes. Would you eat the potatoes out your hair?
Yes. Easy for me. Just a slick head of potatoes. I mean,
just a slick head of potatoes.
No, but you got to do the beard too, Jordy.
Who's hungry?
Just a slick head of potatoes.
Got roasted garlic potatoes behind my ear.
Grandpa Jordy.
Happy Thanksgiving, kids.
Would you rather have to cook the entire Thanksgiving meal alone or clean up all Thanksgiving dishes after the meal alone?
I mean,
is this even close?
I loathe cleaning. And not only that, like, Thanksgiving's one of those holidays where you got the special dishes. The ones that can't go in the dishwasher, you got to hand clean that stuff. No, thank
you. How much
you.
Anxiety does the dirty dish rack give you on Thanksgiving? I mean, it just stacks up. Yeah, I'd definitely
China.
Rather cook.
Here's
rather
the
cook
thing. If I'm the one cooking
fun.
All of that alone. No, if you're cooking that alone, I don't think, look, I'm not going to do a good job if I'm doing it by myself. And then everyone will be looking at me being like, well, thanks for the terrible Thanksgiving meal.
So you're going to clean all the stuff?
Well, you should taste the homemade loaf of banana bread that I baked last night, Nathan.
Is that
because
all you're going to be making?
It's pretty incredible.
That's all you get for Thanksgiving is this homemade banana bread.
No, point being, I think that cooking's fun, and I think the dishes are the worst part about cooking. So, of course, I'd rather cook the meal than clean it up. Nathan, you come to my house, and then you can clean it all up. Deal? You good?
Are you just making banana bread?
No. Would you rather eat Thanksgiving with your family, your Thanksgiving meal with your family, or eat with three celebrities of your choice?
Celebrities of my
choice. Celebrities?
Any celebrity.
Who would they be?
Oh, I don't know that. But I do know that I like celebrities more than I like my family.
I would eat with Jon Favreau, and Jon Favreau. I just want three Jon Favreaus to be sitting
didn't
at the table with
George
me.
Didn't even throw George Lucas in there.
It's a lot of creativity
a
on the table,
lot of
man.
Creativity.
Everything's going to be gold.
A lot of creativity. Actually, give me Jon Favreau, Dave Filoni, and George Lucas, and we'll just talk about Star Wars the entire time. Who would you? You never answered. Family or celebrities?
Family. I'm Italian, man.
Yeah, okay.
Can't break
fair.
The bond.
That's fair. Would you rather be a turkey farmer or a pilgrim?
A pilgrim.
I'm not sure what goes into turkey farming, but I feel like maybe it's not that easy.
I just feel like being a pilgrim was probably terrible. I mean, right? The original Thanksgiving story is just like, we are going to die this winter because it sucks living here so much, and we don't have food, and we don't have houses, and
you have weird diseases.
People are dying left and right. Like, no, I would not want to be a pilgrim at all. Plus, how many days on the boat, Rivers, to get over here?
66 days.
66 days in the open ocean. 66 days of waking up and not seeing land.
I just know that farming anything, I would be terrible at. Whether it be turkey,
then
soybean,
maybe you just have to
or
feed them? I don't know.
Cotton, I'd be terrible.
Hey, I'd just hire people to work the turkey farm.
I guess that's true. You could hire someone.
I mean, if you're a pilgrim,
I'm in.
You're doing the farming anyway. You're like, oh, I got
to
build this house today. Yeah, and I got
to
do all this stuff. And
Michael O'Reagan,
got to go hunt.
Hat with a buckle, though.
Oh, that's a great point. That's a great point by Michael. I mean, the pilgrim style is impeccable. All right, those are our Thanksgiving. Those are our Thanksgiving.
Okay, I do always wonder, it's in the opening, would you rather date the blind or the deaf? I do wonder that every time it's mentioned.
It depends on what you look like.
Yeah.
Maybe you have a really sexy voice, but face isn't doing it so much.
I would say deaf.
Me too.
Because then you learn sign language and you're kind of bilingual at that point.
I'd probably go the deaf as well.
Yeah.
I like a quiet atmosphere.
Plus, like, you know, then you can still enjoy, like, movies together and other things like that. Yeah. Like, yeah, no doubt. Yeah. Would you rather?
No
thank you for
talk.
Jumping in there, Nathan.
You hear that new album?
No small talk. Would you rather? Here, okay, from Jacob Zachary. Would you rather live knowing LSU will lose every game from now on until the end of the world? Or live knowing the end of the world is predicated on the next LSU loss? So like they will lose every game until the end of the world, or they can win, but the next time they lose, the world ends.
No. What?
Come Hell on. Yeah, go Tigers, Nathan.
Yeah, come on, Nate. I mean, think about it though. Think about it.
I mean, this is an easy answer for me.
I've come in, yeah. No,
sorry, LSU. Yeah. Also, is this in every sport or just football? Are
just
they losing
football.
Everything?
No, just football. We'll say just football.
Every gymnastics meet?
No, just football. But I mean, I don't know, though. I've talked a lot on this show about the emotions that these games make me feel, the big ones this year, and how, like, nothing else in entertainment makes you feel that way, the highs and the lows. Can you imagine if the end of the world was riding on it?
Oof.
Like, what that third quarter at Bama would have felt like, Or like Cole Tracy lining up for a game-winning kick last year.
Don't take the sack!
Like, hell yeah, dude. Give me the end of the world. I'm riding or dying with my Tigers.
Go ride a roller coaster.
We got Joe Brady. I'll roll, man. Yeah. Joe Brady and Burrow. Let's roll.
Woo! Bring it on, God! would you rather have the instant knowledge of Google, so your brain is essentially Google.
Ooh, which would be totally tight.
But you are very financially poor. Or you are one of the dumbest people on the planet Earth. You're just dumb as a rock, but you're rich as hell.
Guy who's got the money.
Yeah, yeah, give me all that.
Like
yeah.
Millionaires.
I think being smart, so there's a lot of pressure with being smart.
Amen.
Everything bothers you.
And who the hell would want to be smart and not rich?
Yeah, you too. Exactly. I'm with you, Rivers.
A waste of strategy.
If you're that smart and you can critically think about things, you're going to be miserable compared to just ignorance.
Everyone
is bliss.
Else around you is going to be so dumb.
Ugh. Ignorance is bliss. Just
who's
be dumb.
Who's the dumb guy in the corner? The rich one.
Yeah, I mean, exactly.
Hey, everyone's
right.
Going to be nice to you. If you're rich, so yeah, get that one.
I think that'll be it.
All right. Would you rather Wednesday? Right. Thanksgiving edition here on Off the Bench.
Wait. Yep. Online.
Yep. Okay.
Would you rather have a human-sized cat or a cat-sized human as a pet?
I don't want any cats.
So you can have a human-sized cat. So like, yeah, I get, but like a domesticated house cat. So like, going to be nice
that
and just kind of fat and lay around, but it's human-sized, yes. Or a human that is cat size.
I think a human that's cat size, like baby. Yeah. So a baby?
No. Like a proportional adult human, but the size of a cat. So they're gonna look like, you know, me and you walking around.
That's kind of cool.
But they're
gonna
be like a
foot tall. That'd be great.
Put it in my pocket.
That would be kind of great.
I actually kind of love that.
I do too. Give me the human-sized cat, or no, the cat-sized human. All right, that's it.